Infrastructure doesn't function in an institutional vacuum. People and resources are needed to operate and maintain it. Unfortunately, in the rush to improve sanitation, infrastructure is often developed with little consideration of the development of the institutional environment. This hinders or even prevents sanitation infrastructure from being well operated and maintained. In turn, this limits its sustainability and decreases its impact on public health, the environment, and equity. To provide sustainable services, an effective sanitation project needs to be much more than just infrastructure and engineering. So what is an effective way to review the whole policy, planning, institutional, technical capacity, financial, and regulatory context? How will these non-technical aspects be discussed with the main stakeholders? And how will the stakeholders prioritise their development and adapt and build on what already exists? The faecal waste flow diagram shows the faecal waste disposal situation in a city. And the City Service Delivery Assessment, or CSDA, shows why the situation is like that. The City Service Delivery Assessment process starts with stakeholder mapping and stakeholder engagement. Using evidence, the CSDA tool creates a traffic light diagram to help stakeholders see the whole existing enabling environment for sewered and non-sewered services. This enables the stakeholders to discuss and prioritise which parts need the most urgent development. This is usually a better process than writing long, complex reports, which are hard to understand and difficult to discuss. Once priorities have been agreed, detailed reports can be more focused and more meaningful. The CSDA shows how finance is converted into effective sanitation services for people. It considers three pillars: enabling, developing, and sustaining services. The enabling pillar assesses the quality of the enabling environment. The developing pillar assesses the extent of sanitation development. And the sustaining pillar assesses the commitment to sustaining services. Each pillar is made up of three indicators. Each indicator is examined for every step of the service chain, from containment to treatment and reuse or disposal. Each indicator is scored and assigned a colour based on that score. The CSDA focuses on the city, but considers national and state or regional institutions and regulations whenever they are relevant. On the left side of the table, you can see the three pillars of enabling, developing, and sustaining services. Each pillar is divided into three indicators, or building blocks, as shown in the second column. Each building block is scored by answering a series of objective questions. For example, in the enabling pillar, under policy, the questions address policy, institutions, and regulation. In another example, in the developing pillar is the indicator equity. This asks questions about the availability of service options and whether services for poor households are included. Sewered and non-sewered sanitation services are provided differently and often by different stakeholders. So, the CSDA questions for sewered sanitation are different to those required for non-sewered sanitation services. But both charts use the same technique to identify and help discuss the strengths and weaknesses of the institutional environment. The CSDA provides a structured assessment diagnosing the main institutional barriers to service delivery. It is designed to engage stakeholders in identifying and discussing these barriers and reaching consensus on the way forward. It asks objective, generic questions about sewered and non-sewered delivery mechanisms across all stages of the service chain. The answers are based on evidence, not opinion. And it's undertaken together with the stakeholders. And it presents the results simply, so they can be debated and discussed. In this module, we've noted that sanitation depends on people and institutions just as much as infrastructure. So it's essential to identify, map, and engage with stakeholders to identify institutional barriers to progress. The CSDA is a systematic, evidence-based tool for assessing the institutional environment. It is also a stakeholder engagement tool that presents the results simply to support a dialogue on setting priorities and mapping out solutions. Doing this will help the stakeholders to buy in to the sanitation solutions they will be developing and managing.